Afternoon, everyone. I am Koppula Kiran, School Assistant Social Studies, working at JPHS Ellapalli, Surapet. Today, we will discussing about 9th class Social Studies lesson, 12th lesson paper 2, Democratic and Nationalist Revolutions, 17th, 18th and 19th centuries. In the chapter, end of the chapter, students can achieve these learning outcomes. Let us start. Students able to learn about globalization. Students know democratic nationalist revolutions. Students understand history divided into ancient, medieval and modern periods. Students know the industrial scientific revolutions. Students understand the colonization. Students appreciate the new inventions. Students able to understand the concepts, liberty, equality, fraternity. These are the democratic ideas. Students locate the map of world, India, England, France, Ireland, America. Okay, let us start coming to the topic modern world and introduction. How to understand the modern world? Today we live in a world where all the countries from everywhere we are interacting each other. How to understand this concept, modern world? This is also known as globalization. How can we understand the globalization concept? Look at the newspaper. Students, all of you look at the newspaper in your home and open the sports page. In the sports page, we are watching different games results, sports results are there. In that sports page, number of different countries teams are there. For example, our Indian teams are also there. These Indian teams played with other countries' teams. This is one thing. Indian teams playing with other teams from different parts of the world. Here it is. In the world, what are the world? Modern world. In the modern world, we are interacting with other countries also. Particularly, sports teams like cricket, volleyball, hockey, football, baseball, whatever it is. In different countries, their national game is there. In this way, and also another example is there. If you look at the products we use every day, for example, we are using daily usage in our home, soaps, mobile phones, toothpaste, and in different kinds of things we are using in home. These things, these goods and services produced from in other countries, not only India. So this is one kind of modern world interacting with others. And also we wear different dresses daily, the way of dresses. These dresses in different countries, different products are there. We can wear it. These products produced in different countries, but now available for us. Another thing is market prices. మార్కెట్ ప్రైసెస్ కనుక చూసినట్లయితే let us, what are the market prices? Particularly, our farmers are using fertilizers, diesel, petroleum. These are also influenced by the market prices. Because of these products produced in different countries. But that products are available for us. For example, multinational companies set up factories and offices for their regular activities. And also Indian companies are setting up factories and offices in other countries. In this way we are observing different sports teams in different countries, different products in different countries produced, different market prices in different countries. These all activities are available in front of us because that is the modern world. Modern world in closely to us. Today we live in a world which is very closely together. It is true that it is not easy to get it. Most of the people migrated. Look at this human history. Most of the people migrated in search for better lands. Why they are migrated from their locality? Because of searching for lands and escaping from famines, droughts, like that. And also diseases also. Not only this, interacting to us, this modern world concept. Number of sailors, we know very well, they adventures on the seas or oceans. Sailors cross the seas, and travelers, pilgrims, and traders cross the mountains, deserts, rivers, and reach to other areas. Kings and soldiers conquered new lands to enlarge their kingdoms. Release. We have seen already kings and queens. Particularly, kings wanted to extend their kingdoms. In this way, they spread their culture also. Another example to progress modern world. Religious teachers, artists and scholars to travel far and wide to spread their ideas and learn new things. Religious teachers and artists, scholars, these are also spread their ideas and learn new things from others. What are the, for example, number of books written by scholars, and they wrote new books and they learn from others also. In this way, our culture spread to the other areas, other countries, and we can learn from other countries. So for the last few centuries, this contact between different parts of the world has grown enormously. So this is known as global village. For example, we lived in our village. We interacting with neighborhoods like that. this process is not easily found it. Our history, world was not a happy history because of religious teachers, artists, scholars, kings and soldiers, travelers, sailors, pilgrims, traders. These are all are visited in different parts of the world. Then they interact with each other. This is the global village developed. But this process is not easily because of wars, conquest, enslavement, slaverism, that means, and displacement of millions of people, and destruction of the natural resources and other forests, domination of one country by another, struggles and wars from freedom. In this process we got this modern world progress. Next. Let us discuss students. It is an activity to do you. Our class was divided into groups. Each group has 5 or 6 students. In this activity, students, what you have available, that means globe, world map, atlas, whatever it is, you look at the globe or world map or atlas. What do you understand? What do you observe from the globe? For example, in this activity, I will give you a newspaper, not me, in your home available. Newspaper is available. Look at the newspaper and observe every group, observe the newspaper, every page. Each group, look at the newspaper and every page. And find out the in it any countries are there, any country. Look at the all advertisements and see if they mention of any foreign country also. Note down the name of the country and the continent in the same way. Okay, share the list every group. Now note the names of the countries that occur mostly frequent. Okay, what did you find from the map? Which countries you found it from the map? Frequently countries are also there. You prepare a posters about one country in every group. You can understand easily what is the globalization. Different countries, you can list out the countries, that country belongs to which continent. List out it. You can understand easily that. Changes that made of the modern world. The integration of the entire world progressed very rapidly from around 1450 CE. This was accompanied by many important changes in the way of people worked, thought and ruled. In this, what is the world progress? How can we find the world progress? Particularly, there are so many changes in this way, world progress and rapid development of the world. There are main features are there, particularly the way of people working, their thoughts and administration. In this process, there are important features of this world progress. Let us discuss one by one. First one is industrial revolution. Look at the picture. Industrial revolution in those days, that means the early days, we were using man-made goods and services. Nowadays we are using different kinds of things made by machines. Very multiple production produced by the machines. This is known as industrial revolution. Tremendous changes in industrial revolution, particularly not only industries and also agricultural sector and also service sector also. In this way, even agriculture, we use modern methods, machines, etc. to produce for sale in the market. This was the result of a major change which we call industrial revolution. Another thing, second one, that is democratic revolution. Nowadays we have seen in this chapter. Second one is most countries today are not ruled by the kings and queens, but by them we are elected democratic process, and also they are answerable to the people. This is a result of the process we called democratic revolution. The third important change, that is today we give to lot of importance to the science, reason and evidence. Do not accept anything with others tell us without questioning them. Using the methods of science and reason, people are trying to understand everything around us. That means about our earth, our universe and life around us and our body, own body, our feelings and thoughts too. This is the result of a process we call scientific revolution. Not only this one, another change is there. That is, last few centuries, a few countries tried to conquer and exploit other countries of the world. Number of countries conquered other countries and exploit them in their natural resources. For example, Britain, European country, came to India and established colonies also called factories. They started trade with us. After some time, they established political authority in India. In this way, number of European countries like Britain, France, Holland, Spain, Russia, Germany, Italy and other countries are established new colonies in Asia, Africa, North America and South American continents. This process is called colonization. Look at the picture. Colonization, British rulers and our Indian rulers. Early modern period, the period between 1450 and 1750 is generally called the early modern period. This period is known as early modern period. In this, for example, traders of India, China, Arabia were carrying goods by sea route to each other countries for every long time. in this means our India, China and Arabian countries trade with different countries, particularly European countries, Italy, Greek, these countries trade with us also. This was done in the early days. In this way, Christopher Columbus, look at the picture, 1450 and 1750, this is the early modern period. Christopher Columbus, he is Italian sailor. Vasco da Gama, he is Portugal sailor. Their kings started inventions and explorations to invent new places. In this way, Christopher Columbus started their traveling. Look at this old map. Christopher Columbus, he belongs to Italy. He started his traveling. Actually, he wanted to find India. He wanted to see route from find to India, but he reached the South America. This South American continent, before him, European countries don't know about South American countries. He invented a new continent, that is American continent. Christopher Columbus, 1492, he started his sea route and invented South America route. And also, this look at that this picture, Portugal Vasco da Gama invented sea route to the India. He reached the western coast area in India, and he appointed our Indian rulers permission. This way, they invented new sea routes. Here it is. There are some main important points about early modern period. The early modern period was also the time when major advances were made in science, particularly astronomy, mathematics, philosophy, etc. During this time, the observations and calculations made by scientists of China, India, Arab countries and Europe were compiled and studied. In this way, great scientist is Galileo arrived at the conclusion that the sun was at the center of the solar system and planets like the earth when around it. Before him, the world was believed Ptolemy's theory. The earth is the center of the solar system. All the planets around it. But after Galileo invented telescope, then it was find it. Next, Nelakanta Somayaji, Descartes and Newton developed new methods for studying movement of planets and stars. These great mathematical scientists, these three persons, Nelakanta Somayaji, Descartes and Newton, all are these. And conclusion. Today we are used to the idea of democratic form of government. In those days, kings, queens and princes were ruled the kingdom. Nowadays there is no kings and queens rule in our era. All the citizens have fundamental rights and are treated as equals by law. In the chapter, we will read about how people fought to build a democratic political system and achieve social equality. Particularly, nowadays we have been watching particular democratic governments everywhere, established democratic governments, parliamentary system like that. And they wanted social equality. In this way, they wanted liberty, that means freedom, equality and dignity. In the following chapters, we will be studying mainly these features. Okay, next. Evaluation. Define globalization. What is meant by industrial revolution? How different would our lives have been if we were ruled by kings? Thank you.